On February from 6 to 8, 2024, an open day was held in the river port in Bratislava under the direction of the Ministry of Transport. The goal was to bring young students from high schools and universities closer to possible future workplace. I'm glad that I could open second event study water transport and tourism on behalf of the Ministry of the Transport, behalf of our Minister of Transport. The aim of the joint event of the Ministry of Transport of the Slovak Republic, colleagues and universities and companies operating in the field of water transport, economy and tourism is to increase the interest of pupils and students in studying in the field of the water transport, water management, gastronomy, hotel management and tourism. In our division, we would mainly expect people who will carry our security on island, waterways, through Slovakia, and these are different positions, from shipping inspectors to the technical departments to the people which administratively ensure safety on inland waterways. As the opening said, Mr. Marek Harbuľák, State Secretary for Tourism and the Minister of Tourism and Sport of the Slovak Republic.
And you young students who are today looking for a job or deciding what profession to pursue today, I think this is a very good message. With this event, we actually want to show that work not only in tourism, but also in transport has its positives. It can be a great career opportunity. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all participants on behalf of companies River Advice and Avalon Group for coming to this event.
Students are increasingly interested in a more modern education system that supports creative work, critical thinking, and is practically oriented. There was a lot of interest in exhibitors. We want to show them teaching method as it is, how they learn with us. That is not always just about theory, but we always try to transfer the theory into practice. Every semester, our students have to do a project in teams of three, which is focused on what they really enjoy. Here it is that the unexpected awaits, because we really originally thought that priority hotel academies and so on. What is the truth? That those kids here find out themselves and continue to do what they know and are often at the practical activities too, more engaged than they know. But high school students have proven themselves very well, and students from technical schools come and suddenly they enjoy it, because actually this part of the study program is management.
We are from the University of Constantine the Philosopher and came to this riverboat to present the opportunity to study culture and tourism management. Our institute offers three study programs that address this issue. They connect. On the one hand, it is a study program, Management of Culture and Tourism, where we teach students how to manage tourism and culture. This means not only the profitable sector, that of tourism, but also the often non-profit sector of culture, where we do not expect any economic profit, but culture is a large part of the offer in tourism. And therefore, it is necessary to convey to the tourists, and rationality of the action is also necessary in the cultural sector. That means all those managerial functions that we apply also in the culture.
The labor market is changing. Younger generations are more determined and are not afraid of new job opportunities. The world around us is witnessing a significant generation change in which millennials are giving way to the tidal wave of Generation Z.
Today's generation of young people entering the workforce. It is very similar. I would not generalize it in the sense that young people do not know anything and are slower or do not want to. And similarly, it is about how we can motivate people. We have people who are young millennials and they were so motivated and liked this job so much that they were able to get a job promotion every second year in one case.
The easiest positions, they should definitely try it. Especially girls who, for example, would like to be an independent, and that's why I do it too. That independence, because of first, as I said, you can make a nice amount of money, and on the second side, you just live on that cruise ship, you don't have any expenses, basically because you have a place to live, you have something to eat, some potential career growth. Because I'm actually the person that Gabriel mentioned, that I actually change the position every second year. That I go higher and higher. We asked experienced and participating managers, directors on the effectiveness of the open day organized by the Ministry of Transport.
Open doors, and we support it because it is important that we inform new generation what really is work on board and what exactly does it entail. We want to attract those people.
How long it takes to get position of captain from beginning of sailor?
2+3, 5, and 4, up to 9 years, indeed. It took me 10 years in my case. And I started as a sailor of first class. And then you need a strong will to reach it. The desire to prove something in life. I would say that you just have to work hard. You need to fulfill your dreams. And then everything is possible. Mainly mentioned discipline is discipline. Then everything is all right.
First of all, it's super exciting to be here and see all this young generation, and they are looking for something to do in their future. And basically our first goal and aim is not necessarily to recruit them to work for us, but to understand what they would like to reach in their future and if we can offer something which is aligning with their goals.
It's a great opportunity to open the doors of a ship and to have young children but also experienced professionals come on board, because for many you see a ship pass by on the river and you look at it and you think, oh, that's nice, but you never realize how many different positions you have on board of a ship. And the only way to experience it is to come actually on board and to speak to the crew and hear from their experiences. So I think it's a great opportunity. And even for young children, it's sometimes very difficult to decide what are you going to do. I have 3 children myself, and also they struggled a bit of what am I going to do. But I think if you have the possibility to visit the ship and to see what is possible, it helps you to make a decision.
Exactly, today it was chance to visit cruise ships docking in harbour in Bratislava for students of secondary grammar schools and universities as well. The Ministry of Transport prepared a wonderful program where they could visit all departments of the ships, talk to people who work on ships with representatives of other companies and learn more about this work. We firmly believe that next year it will be also a great opportunity for another students who will be interested in a work on board cruise ships or in this industry in the future.